Hello everyone! I hope that everyone is feeling great, but if not, please try to relax. I'm asking you to close your eyes, take a deep breath, and then breathe out, think about something good, and then open your eyes and smile and continue to watch this video. So, for people who see me for the first time, let me introduce myself. I'm Victoria Moore, a fashion blogger and stylist from Miami. I upload a new video every week, so if you still not subscribed to my channel, please do, and let's get started. In today's video, I will show you the most common style mistakes that people make in winter, as well as explain how to fix them. So, the first mistake is quite significant, is that we wear the same color almost all the time in winter, and most often it is black. I think you have noticed that in the fall and especially in the winter, most of the people switch to monochrome combination in their clothes. I think this is most likely due to the fact that it gets dark early in winter, the city looks darker, the sun is no longer shining so brightly, and in general, the whole atmosphere looks a little bit depressing and deprives us of any desire to dress in bright colors. And to be honest, I myself am not an exception to this rule. I also notice the urge to wear something neutral in the winter season. Do you know what could be worse? That is to choose an outfit in one neutral color from the same texture. So, what should we do in that case? If you really, really want to dress only in neutral muted colors and shades, then in this case, I recommend at least mixing textures in order to add depth to the image. To do this, you need to mix different materials in the same image. For example, you can put on leather pants, a silk shirt on top, and a knit cardigan on top of it. And then, even if your image consists only one color, it will still not look boring due to the diverse textures. Of course, to make it even more interesting, I recommend adding some kind of bright accessories. It can be a bright belt, scarf, hat, shoes, or bag. In this case, thanks to contrasting accessories, our image will sparkle in a completely new way and will no longer look so dull and simple. Okay. The next mistake, which I also see pretty much often, is when fur colors are combined with accessories made of fur too. For example, you are wearing a fur coat and add a hat made of fur and also the same gloves, which together will look a little bit ridiculous, again, due to the oversaturation of the same material in the same outfit. Of course, you can wear a fur coat with a fur hat and a sheepskin coat with sheepskin hat, whatever you want. But if you would like to work a little on your winter wardrobe and make it more interesting and stylish, then I still recommend mixing different textures even for the top layers of the clothes. I would advise wearing fur coats with something super contrasting, such as cashmere cap or at least a beanie, in order to preserve and emphasize the interesting of the image and its depth. Another very common mistake is when you're wearing a few layers of clothes in the same length. Let me explain what do I mean. Quite often, I see people on the streets who try to dress according to the principle of layering, but at the same time forget I do not know the well-known style rule about the different length of the items that we put on one of top on the other. The rule itself sounds like this. The lowest layer of clothing should always be the longest, and all subsequent layers should be shorter than it. For example, you put on a long short and wear a cardigan sweater or vest over it, which ends before the shirt. Thus, you create the correct proportions and your image begins to play in a completely new way. And to make your look 100% more stylish, I recommend choosing a thinner layer under the bottom and a denser material for the second and third layer of your look. For example, your shirt can be made of silk and the vest is made of chunky knit of a sufficiently dense material that will not show throughout your underwear or short underneath. Another mistake that I often see is a wrong choice of trousers, which in some cases look rather ridiculous with winter shoes. For example, I have often noticed girls on the streets who wear not very narrow and not very wide, but long trousers that hang with folds on the shoes, and thus the whole image begins to look like something all quark and unkept. To avoid this mistake, I recommend replacing the trousers with wider ones so that they simply do not gather at the bottom, or you can use special trousers with the stirrups, which because of this style will solve this problem by themselves. Also, we have another option you can choose, simply short thread models that will end before the start of the shoe, but the only drawback in a specific version is that in that case that you can feel chill, and therefore by choosing this option I recommend to add a sock to cover the open part of the leg. And the last common mistake that I would like to talk about is when there is no balance of proportion in the outfit. I perfectly understand a girl who dress like that because we all want to wrap ourselves up in something warm and comfortable, especially when it's cold. And we don't have any reasons to dress up. But then, in the image, there will be a complete lack of balance, and thus you will look non-structured and shapeless. This kind of clothing will not only not emphasize the dignity of your figure, but on the contrary will present only the worst sides of it. That is why I recommend to don't forget about this rule and to do something structuring in the image that will hold the image, and something on the contrary softer and move relaxed. For example, it can be joggers and a structured jacket, or on the contrary, a hoodie and a silk shirt. In this case, you will get quite stylish look. Therefore, it is very important to find a middle ground where we have both structured things and soft things. And in any case, remember that you are great just because you watched this video and took another step forward to find a modern and stylish wardrobe. And just remember that everything comes with practice, and therefore the best way to learn something is in constantly try to do something new and not afraid to experiment. Alright guys, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and found useful for yourself. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up. If you like it, I will really appreciate it. Bye everyone, and I will see you in my next video.